Menstrual cycle. What is meant by menstrual cycle? It is the periodic changes which occurs in the female reproductive system. The periodic changes which occurs in the female reproductive system is called as menstrual cycle. Now let us see this terminologies. What is meant by menarche and menopause? Menarche means it is the that stage in the female reproductive system where it will be the stage of puberty begins. That means the stage of puberty, that is 12 to 13 years of age. This is called as the age of puberty in the females, young girls, that is called as menarche. And these days, due to the different types of food and the environmental conditions, menarche is occurring even at the lower age, even at 9 to 10 years also in some cases. And the menopause is that stage which is occurring in the females, especially that is in the female reproductive system, at the age of 45 to 55 years in the females. You can say this as the middle age or the old age in case of the females. So these are the two terminologies which you have to remember in your minds, that menarche and menopause. These are the main terminologies in the menstrual cycle. Not only that, they are influencing a lot in the females. All these things will be influenced by the hormones, and these hormones are again secreted from the anterior gland of the pituitary. So hormones plays a very vital role in the female reproductive system. Now let us see what is meant by this menstrual cycle. This we can also say in simple words as a reproductive cycle. Reproductive cycle. This reproductive cycle can be divided into two cycles for our easy understanding. Okay. This is called as, the first one is called as the estrous cycle, and the second one is called as the menstrual cycle. What is estrous cycle? It occurs in the non-primates. What are non-primates? These are not human beings. They are mammals. They are no doubt mammals, but they are the non-primates. That means they are not human beings. And menstrual cycle occurs in the primates. Primates means in the man, not only in man, but also in monkeys. Chimpanzees, all the different types of species of monkeys, definitely you find the menstrual cycle. Now what is seen in the estrous cycle? That is example dog, buffalo, sheep, horses, okay, cats, etc. So all these things are the non-primates. The non-primates, you see the estrous cycle. What is the difference between an estrous cycle and a menstrual cycle? Here estrous cycle is that cycle which occurs in the organisms only during the reproductive period. But in the menstrual cycle, what will happen? Even though the reproductive cycle will occur, but it occurs in every month. That is the main difference. Here every month you can see in the females the menstrual cycle, in man, monkeys, chimpanzees and all. But here in the estrous cycle, in all these non-primates, it is seen only in the reproductive period. Understood? So this is the basic idea about the reproductive cycle or the menstrual cycle. Now let us discuss about the different phases of the menstrual cycle. What are the different phases of the menstrual cycle which is influencing the females right when they are in the womb of the mother? Understood? Not even when they are not even born, when they are in the mother's womb, that is from the third month, or the I can say from the first month of pregnancy, the female's menstrual cycle, or in other words the reproductive cycle, will start. Yes, what is that, how is that, we will discuss in detail. So the phases of menstrual cycle, this is called as the uterine phase, and the another one is called as the ovarian phase. Very very important stages in the females. Okay, what is uterine phase? Uterine phase is that phase, in other words, in a very simple words I'll tell you, uterine phase is the other name for uterine phase is called as the bleeding phase. It is also called as the bleeding phase in young women, young girls, young ladies, young women. So we can divide like that, the human females. Are you following? So the uterine phase or the bleeding phase will last from 1 to 5 days. That depends upon the body nature, environmental conditions, genetics, so many things will come and play a very vital role in this particular days. It may vary from 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 5 or 1 to 7 days also. Okay, and all those conditions and all, at this stage it is not essential for you. You have to remember is that the stage, uterine phase or bleeding phase, will last from 1 to 5 days. Now what is ovarian phase? Ovarian phase is lasting from 5 to 28 days, which is important for any female or the human's female reproductive system. Why I am constantly telling this? Because this is the phase where the generations, from one generation to another generation, or the cycles will be influenced or characterized by only this particular phase, which is called as the ovarian phase. Now if you see this cycle, this is the, I am showing in a very a brief structure of the menstrual cycle. Here this is the cycle of complete 1 month, 30 days, how the female reproductive system or the menstrual cycle or the reproductive cycle is being influenced by different types of hormones and how they are playing a vital role in their life. Understood? So when you see this cycle, you can see that in this cycle, this is the first day, this is the first day of their menstrual cycle or the reproductive cycle. The shaded portion which I have shaded, this one, this is called as, this stage is called as the uterine phase or the bleeding phase, which lasts from 1 to 5 days. Okay, am I clear? So this is the shaded portion in the menstrual cycle is called as the bleeding phase. Understood? Now next stage, we call this as the follicular phase. What is the follicular phase? Yes, already in the previous class we have seen the structure of the ovum, and we have also discussed about the different types of follicles. Now how exactly it is occurring in this particular follicular phases? The primary follicle, that means immediately after the uterine phase, the primary follicle is formed. This primary follicle will be converting into the secondary follicle. Primary follicle is converting into the secondary follicle, and secondary follicle is converting into the tertiary follicle. All these follicles are forming only in presence of one hormone, which is called as follicle stimulating hormone, FSH. So follicle stimulating hormone, from where it is coming? From the anterior gland of the pituitary. So that is, the anterior gland of pituitary will release this hormone, which is called as follicle stimulating hormone, only after the 5 days of the menstrual cycle. Are you following? So before it will not release. So everything is connected in the females. It is not like in males. It is very, very complicated. Okay. So after the fifth day only, with the influence of follicle stimulating hormone, the primary follicles will be formed. This after cytogenesis or cell divisions, again it will be growing into the secondary follicle. Secondary follicle will be growing into the tertiary follicle, and also you know that there the tertiary follicle is getting the nutrition from the antrum, is it not? From the antrum, and hence with this development it grows into the next stage, which is called as the Graafian follicle. The Graafian follicle will be formed after the tertiary follicle, again with the influence of follicle stimulating hormone. This Graafian follicle will grow in size, big size, on the 14th day of this reproductive cycle. If the girl or a female is a normal, healthy, without any problems or any hormonal problem, definitely on the 14th day, definitely this Graafian follicle has to be formed. If it is not formed, again there are many hormonal problems with that particular females, maybe due to stress or strain, or maybe many other reasons will also play a role. Okay, so on this 14th day Graafian follicle will be formed, and this will be forming or emerging into the next stage called as corpus luteum. This corpus luteum will be ready to form the corpus albinus in presence of luteinizing